The son of PDP Laban co-founder, the late Senator Nene Pimentel, condemns the Cusi faction's endorsement of Marcos Jr. Senator Coco Pimentel notes the disconnect with their party's anti-Marcos roots. For more on his reaction, we are joined this morning by Senator Pimentel, who is the chairman of the PDP Laban Pacquiao faction. Senator Pimentel, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for inviting me, and good morning, Mike, Nikki, and to all of the televiewers.
All right, Senator, first, the PDP Laban Cusi faction endorsement of Bongbong Marcos, was this a surprise to you, or you saw this coming all along?
We saw that coming. These people have been looking for a presidential candidate to endorse, and they have been lost for quite a while. No? They have had quite a journey endorsing around not less than three to four names already. So ito pong grupo na ito ay talagang naghahanap ng presidential candidate siguro para makapapel, mapansin, mapansin. So that's what they're doing. Actually, I think they did this for judging from how quickly the presidential candidate Marcos pounced on the so-called endorsement to use it for the media value. So I think they did this just for media purposes because, you know, we already have an internal dispute. Now we have expelled these people from the party. Mm-hmm. And I think that this move of theirs actually weakens their own faction because not all of those who went with Secretary Cusi will support Marcos for president under the PDP Laban, bringing the PDP Laban name. So this weakens them, but they did this for media purposes. So wag po tayong magpadala sa mga pronouncement na ganito, lalo na yung mga old-timer PDP Laban members and even the new ones who have found satisfaction with the party. Wag po tayong magpadala sa gimmick na ito.
Mm-hmm. But the question here, Senator, is the PDP Laban endorsement of Marcos, at least the Cusi faction, is that also indicative of the president's support for Mr. Marcos himself? I mean, do you see the president campaigning for Mr. Marcos despite what he has said about Bongbong Marcos?
I hope not, and I hope that the statement made by Secretary Martin Andanar is also true, correct, and accurate, and not, again, another joke. No, but I'm hoping that this is not the endorsement of the president because it has actually been Secretary Cusi who has been so politically imaginative for the past how many months, you know. But without real solid planning, he has been to four presidential candidates. So I think this is his style. You know? So and they always use the media just to maximize the exposure or publicity of their stunts. So anyway, I'm just calling on all the real PDP Laban members who have been with us for the longest time or for a long time, and for the new ones who believe in the party principles, if we really know the history of our party, we cannot possibly endorse Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Marami naman choices dyan eh. And we have already, the PDP Laban, the real one, already made its choice. It's Senator Manny Pacquiao for president, who we endorse in a formal ceremony or process following our party constitution.
You don't believe the reason given by the Cusi faction that supposedly former Senator Marcos is the best candidate aligned with the principles or with the objectives of President Duterte?
So if we analyze that statement, they're not really PDP Laban members or ideologues because they look at the personality. Doon lang sila eh. This choice is the best choice to follow this person. Hindi po kami ganoon. If you're a real PDP Laban member and you understand the principles of the party of PDP Laban, you know that we should follow our party principles. Okay? We want to lessen personality-based politics. From that statement alone, halata na natin na si Secretary Cusi is just following a person and then hoping that the person that they're enjoying will notice them, and after the elections, kung sakaling they are victorious, will remember him. We are not like that in PDP Laban. We have five basic principles, and then we also pursue federalism as a basic objective. Yun po tayo, doon kami, focus kami sa party principles po dapat, not personality.
Senator, in your statement yesterday, you called the Cusi faction a total stranger for not acknowledging that PDP Laban was established to oppose the Marcos dictatorship. Remind us again, how was PDP Laban founded and what was the vision of your late father, Senator Nene Pimentel?
PDP Laban is the merger of two political parties. The first one is PDP, organized basically in Mindanao and Visayas to oppose the Marcos dictatorship, you know, to fight for our freedoms, for our democratic values, or to reestablish democracy. Yan po yung Laban eh. And then Laban is a Metro Manila or Luzon-based political party which fielded candidates in the 1978 Batasan elections to oppose and to fight the KBL slate. Ganun po yun. The KBL slate would be the one bringing the ideology or the thinking of Marcos. The Laban slate would be the one opposing, checking the KBL slate on the basis of Democrat or the need for checks and balances under the democracy. So ganun po yon. So nagsama po yung Luzon-based Laban and Visayas Mindanao-based PDP to make it PDP Laban in 1982.
So, and Laban, Senator, just sorry to cut you off, but Laban was also founded by the late Senator Ninoy Aquino.
That's correct. So Ninoy Aquino and Lorenzo Tañada. And how was my father able to bring together the two groups? Because he is the common denominator. He ran and my father, Senator Nene Pimentel, ran under the Laban ticket in the 1978 elections here in Metro Manila. And when he went back to Cagayan de Oro City, he formed PDP. So he became the bridge between the two political parties, and then they merged to become one stronger national party, which still survives up to today after 40 years. So marami na kaming pinagdaanan, Mike. Marami na pong mga attempts to grab power within the party. This is not the first time. Nadaanan na po namin ito.
Now, Senator, as you mentioned, almost 40 years since its founding, but you now have the ruling party split into two factions and without a standard bearer for the May 2022 polls. How did PDP Laban end this way? And I mean, what happened?
Yeah, because of the gimmicks of Secretary Cusi. He really wanted to bring the party to an outsider. So that was the root cause of our difference. So the legitimate PDP Laban endorsed Senator Manny Pacquiao, a genuine member of PDP Laban, okay, as our party presidential candidate. But only because of the dispute, as a matter of strategy and to keep the Cusi faction off balance, Senator Manny Pacquiao used the certificate of nomination of another political party. But he's still with PDP Laban. That is allowed under COMELEC rules.
And on a point of curiosity, Senator Pimentel, is Secretary Cusi a genuine member of PDP Laban as you define it?
No, because Secretary Cusi failed to comply with our basic membership requirements.
When did he join?
He joined during the campaign of President Duterte in 2016. Yeah, campaign. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. No, you talked about Senator Pacquiao, his choice. He was a choice of your faction, at least. To what extent do you think this rift was can be attributed to Senator Manny Pacquiao's election as president of the party?
Yeah, it's related to the presidential election. Because I'm sure Secretary Cusi wanted to appear to be the person who will bring a bulk of votes to his chosen presidential candidate. And why do you do that? so that if your chosen presidential candidate wins, hopefully you will be remembered. That is it. So, but that is the trap way. The real PDP Laban way is we stick to our five basic principles, our basic objectives. We look for the person who will commit to pursue in case he wins the election. And then this person, if he loses, he will continue to pursue the basic principles and the basic objective as seen, as could be seen from his life and lifestyle. Ganun po dapat ang PDP Laban mag-isip, hindi yung parati namang transactional.
Mm-hmm. Now, your Vice Chairman, Lutgardo Barbo, has blamed the President for hijacking the party and has on several occasions expressed regret that the party adopted him in the 2016 elections. Do you share the same sentiment?
Well, there should be no regrets because what might have been is an abstraction. So if somebody else won the 2016 election, what would have happened? Hindi na natin alam yun. So we live with what we have, we live with our decisions, and then still plan ahead. Ganon din po yun. Under President Duterte, federalism became a hot topic. A lot of people studied it here and abroad. The issue was discussed. So even the lack of understanding became apparent. So one lesson under the Duterte administration is if we really want federalism to continue and to be implemented here in the Philippines, we need still to study it deeper, discuss it a lot for the education of everybody.
Do you think the president was sincere in pushing for federalism? Because after you have this group proposing a new constitution, nothing happened after that.
But there were steps, Mike. There were steps. The topic was discussed. People were mobilized, and now we have published books about it. So, countries which practice it also extended support. I know this personally, so at least there was a propagation of the idea. So in that sense, it helped the cause of federalism.
Senator, let me just go back to this because a big question really was how your father, a human rights champion, came to support then-Mayor Rodrigo Duterte for his 2016 presidential bid when he was already accused of human rights violations in Davao City. So you think the goal of promoting federalism trumps that record of then-Mayor Rodrigo Duterte?
Well, human rights is the topic of human rights is very important also. Same with federalism. But, you know, ito kasi yung problema. In the PDP Laban, we do not want to immediately judge people. We do not want to discriminate against people. At yan nga yung hinanakit ko sa Cusi group. When it was Manny Pacquiao, they looked down on him. You know, discriminating against him. So we believe that, you know, we should not discriminate against people. We should not judge them immediately. And we also believe in giving people second chances. So ganun po siguro yun. We balance everything. Plus the fact that he was a party member. So ganun po yun eh. So that is very important. That you know, you did not just come out of nowhere applying to become a party member because you are running. That's a different story. But if you had been a party member for a long time, you have political ambitions, therefore the party should entertain your political and give you a chance.
Senator, with all that happened, are you still an ally of the president? I mean, after all the insults hurled against you and with what happened to the party split into two, do you consider yourself still an ally of the president?
No longer a personal ally because we don't talk anymore. We are no longer party mates because when he made the substitution with the PDDS candidate, automatically he became PDDS, a member of the PDDS party because that's what the rules say. You can only substitute for a candidate who has filed a certificate of candidacy if you are from the same party of that person. So, but in that case, but of course, if there are programs in the remaining days of his term that are good for the Filipino people, yung helping the poorest of the poor, support po tayo dyan. But if it's about you know, adding firearms into our territory. Let's start to resist that. Dapat may priorities na po tayo. Yung kahirapan na muna ng taong bayan ang unahin po natin.
Senator, do you take personal responsibility though for what happened to PDP Laban? Because you were head of PDP Laban for quite some time. So the fact that this happened under your watch, that you were in fact unseated during a meeting in, I think that was in somewhere up north. Do you take personal responsibility for this?
I do not know if I was unseated because I'm still chairman of the party as far as we are concerned. You know? Mm-hmm. And it was a peaceful transition of the presidency of the party from me to Senator Manny Pacquiao. So as I've stated earlier, Mike, this is not the first time that there is a power grab within PDP Laban. Okay, so this is probably the third or fourth time. Mm-hmm. The other incidents happened when I was still a teenager. Maybe then the other one, I was 20 years old or 30 years old. So these things happen. Do not blame yourself because this is politics. People have a hidden agenda when they join your political party. We make mistakes in welcoming them to the party in good faith. For as long as I acted in good faith, I accept the consequences, but we will fight, di ba? Lalabanan namin, di ba? No one will be allowed to hijack PDP Laban just because you want to hijack it and offer it to somebody who is not deserving of the blood, sweat, tears, time, and energy invested by genuine PDP Laban members over 40 years. Oh, so we will resist it. Mas mayaman sila sa amin, mas magaling sila sa media, may mga media handler sila, but we will still resist it. Ganun lang po yun.
Do you consider it a mistake though, admitting some of these members whom you said were not genuine PDP Laban members after the 2016 elections? Because I recall your father did warn PDP Laban against accepting this exodus of politicians and government officials into the PDP Laban faction shortly after the election of President Duterte.
That's correct. This has also happened before. So a mistake was repeated, but you know, it's very difficult, Mike, in reality, kasi, you know, it's very difficult. You, in good faith, you assume that they really want to pursue the five basic principles, the objective of federalism, because that is what they say. And then you also believe in giving people second chances. So they come from another party, which once upon a time they oppose you, they want to join you now. So in good faith, everything was done. But we learn our lessons. Ganun na lang po.
Mm-hmm.
No need to, you know, go in a corner and then regret everything and cry. We fight back. PDP Laban pa tayo, we fight back.
But can this be a case study for the argument that there should be a law against turncoatism?
Yes. Because actually, when this happened, immediately one thought which came into my mind is probably there should be a law against turncoatism. But you know, but I hope that joining a party should really be out of agreement with the party principles. Kasi even if we have a law against turncoatism, but if you join just to use the party, you know, somehow there will still be more breach violations of the law than compliance. So dapat ganon. So after this election, I promised my members who are still with me now in PDP Laban, together with Senator Manny Pacquiao, with his help, there will be a cleansing of the PDP Laban. If we will be reduced to a very small number, so be it. But we will have to rebuild the party. This time, looking for people, members who really will believe, you know, in the five basic principles and the objective of federalism. Not join the party for these principles. Do not join the party just because of the upcoming election. Doon na po kami doon na talaga kami magbabantay po. Although we tried to do it, mahirap lang po talaga in real life and Philippine setting and Philippine culture, Mike. But we will do some cleansing process in PDP Laban.
What has happened to that pending petition in the COMELEC, Senator Pimentel, as to who is the real PDP Laban faction?
Still pending. That's mm-hmm. why it's high time for the COMELEC to decide on the petition filed by CUSI, by the way, questioning mm-hmm. our leadership of the party. So they admit that we are the leaders of the party, except that they want to replace us. Unfortunately for them, what they did yesterday, I think we can use against them. So I have talked to our lawyer to document what happened yesterday, their endorsement of a candidate who is the antithesis of the philosophy of PDP Laban. So if you do that, that means you are not really a genuine member of PDP Laban. So we will use what they did yesterday as evidence against them that they mm-hmm. do not understand a thing about this political party which they claim to lead. So mm-hmm. it's high time that the COMELEC should, you know, now see the truth, the reality, and then quickly dismiss their case, their petition.
Lastly, Senator, what were your last conversations with your father before he died about where your party is headed? I mean, how do you think he would react if he were alive right now?
No, because my father is true to his word. He told me that he would already retire from running the party. So he never micromanaged or he never criticized or commented on how I was running the party. But he was always available for advice if someone should seek his wise counsel.
So how do you think he would have reacted right now?
He would be sad, but he has seen this also in his time, you know, this power grab. Ganyan po talaga. I think, Mike, kaya siguro nga nagkamayroon tayong kasabihan sa Pilipino na ako ang nagtanim, ako ang nag-ani, ako ang nagluto, ako ang nagsaing, pero iba. Biglang pag ready na po yung paghanda na yung pagkain, iba ang gustong kumain or makinabang doon sa pinaghirapan ng iba. So, kaya siguro tayo nagkaroon ng ganyang saying. Kasi marami tayong mga kasamahan, unfortunately, nasa politika pa, nasa leadership positions pa, na ganyan po mag-isip. Pinaghirapan mm-hmm. ninyo ng 40 taon, ha? O di, kami na, kunin na namin yan at ilalako namin sa mga politiko. Eh, hindi po kami papayag.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Senator Coco Pimentel.
Thank you very much.